So hey guys, thank you very much for joining this time as well. Today is a bit different. I'm live on Facebook, which is doing some crazy things, and I'm live on TikTok. So I'll be doing this presentation here. I'm not live on YouTube this time, but I'll upload the video to YouTube as well. So those of you who follow me on YouTube will not miss this video. Okay, so today's topic is dealing with Czech authorities and giving you some tips and tricks on how to deal with Czech authorities. Because if you're a foreigner and if you want to live in the Czech Republic long term, then you will definitely at some point be dealing with some Czech authorities. For most of you, the first experience will be already the Ministry of the Interior or the Foreign Police, which can be a very pleasant experience, I must say. For some of you, it will be later on when you need to exchange your trade license or if you need to get some documents from the tax office. I was at the Ministry of the Interior today with the client from the US, and one of her worst experiences here was at the when she was exchanging her or when she was getting a Czech driver's license. And that's a wonderful office there as well. So today I'll be giving you tips on how to deal with Czech authorities whenever you need to deal with them. So I'll go through 6 tips and I'll always go a bit deeper in the topic. And of course, if you have any questions, feel free to ask, because this will be a bit different than usually. So I'll be able to react right away. So tip number one, when you're going to any Czech office, is to make a great first impression. Because it's I've been in sales for 10 or 15 years of my adult life, and this is the golden rule of sales. That's the first 3 seconds, it's on TikTok, is the same. The 2-3 first seconds make the whole impression of you, and based on those seconds, people will be treating you some way based on the impression you give. So this is the same with Czech authorities. If you go there and you behave like they're there for you and they have to do everything you want, they will not do that. So you need to kind of, but what really helps me when I go somewhere is obviously to smile at them, because it's a small thing. You say, hey, yeah, obviously that's like, that's a stupid thing to advise, but it really works. If I go there and I do like, hello, how are you? How are you today? It makes a completely different impression than if I go and say just like, hello, how are you? So like, smile is very important, but it's not only about the smile, it's also the first sentence you tell them. So I usually try to, but I'll get to it later, but I usually try to establish some kind of rapport. I try to make them laugh or make them, you know, have a good impression. So like, first sentence, the smile, first sentence, that's always the most important. So that's tip number one. I can get more into that, and I'll get to similar things, similar parts of that in the next point. So tip number two, how to deal with Czech authorities, would be to let them have some power over you, because that's what they like. You know, they are the authority. They are there to either make your life easy or make your life complicated. They can decide themselves. And you want to give them this power. Obviously, it's kind of scary to give them the power, but if you do it in the way that you manage the power, then it's actually a very great great thing to do. So what I usually do is that we, for example, when we go to the Ministry of the Interior, then we don't sign the form right away in advance. You could do that, but we don't do that, because or we leave some pieces of the application blank, because then they are going through the application anyway. And if they see that something is missing, they will say, hey, you forgot this. And you can say, oh, really? Oh, thank you very much for pointing that out. Let's sign it right now. So that's very helpful, because it's a small thing. It will not change anything in your application if you don't sign it like in advance, but you sign it in front of them. But it will completely change their attitude, because they will have this wrong. You need to do it again, or you need to sign here, and it will give them power. Another way how I do this is that I usually sit lower than them. So if their head is here, I usually sit like this, because it usually also gives them the power. They're higher than you. So those are like psychological tricks, which will make them feel better and more important than you, but it will not change anything in the whole like context. So that's tip number two. Tip number three, it's actually very important, and that's come there prepared, or go there prepared, because you know some of the officers are pissed like by nature. Yeah, even if you smile and you'll be like asking them questions and complimenting them everything, they will not care. They will be still grumpy and they will still have like bad mood because that's their setup. You cannot really change it much. But if they are in a bad mood and you come there and you have half of the required documents, it will piss them even more. You know, so you want to go there and have as many documents ready as possible. Be prepared also in the sense that the previous tip was to let them have the power. So they should feel like they know more than you. In some cases, they will also know more than you, but in many cases, you will know more than them. Or if you at least prepare in advance, you know what to expect. You know what you can do and what they can do and what they cannot do. So it's always good to go there prepared, especially if you need to deal with some official authorities. It's good to prepare. Because many people, again, I've seen it a million times, they come there, they think like, let's say people going, for example, to the Ministry of the Interior. They go there, they act like everyone owes them everything, that the officers are there only for them. They only have like two documents and the 10 other documents are missing. And then they behave like, you know, shouting there. And this will not make your application go better. So if you make a great first impression, you smile, you compliment them, you ask questions, and you just establish the rapport, you're prepared for the appointment. So you know what you want to accomplish, what you want to do there. You have all the documents with you, at least reasonably all, and what you could find out and what you could bring. And if you let them have some power over you, that will help you with the process. So these are four important tips. Then I also have two more. One of them I've already touched that, and that would be tip number five, compliment them or acknowledge how hard their job is. Because it's true that on one hand, we only see it from this side. Like we go there and they try to make our life complicated at the authority. But from their side, it's like nonstop client after client after client after client. And if you combine it with what I was talking about before, that many people come there unprepared, they are rude, you know, they don't compliment them at all. They just like go there and expect the authority to do everything they want. It must be difficult, you know, for them. And if you acknowledge that, if you say, hey, I've seen that you've had already like 20 clients leaving, so it must be very difficult for you today. How is it? Like, how you deal with that? I would get crazy if I was in your place. That will also like, you will completely, you will see the complete change in their attitude and in their eyes and everything. And they will really help you go through that because you acknowledge them, you make them feel like nice and like acknowledged. So this is another tip. And of course, compliment them, but it should be a real compliment. So if you see that they have a nice scarf, for example, tell them, wow, you have a beautiful scarf. Where did you get it? That really helps. Compliment them for their work as well, especially if you're finished. When they did everything you needed or you did everything you needed and you leave in, thank them and compliment them as well. Like I often say, hey, if everyone was as fast as you, that would be amazing because you've done a great job today. Because maybe that will not help you now, but first, it will help other people after you, which is good. And second, it will help you when you come back. Because if you compliment them, they will remember you. If you're just one of the people shouting at them, most likely they will not remember you. So complimenting them during the process and before you leave is always a good idea as well. And then the sixth tip is kind of related to all of this. Be nice to them because they are just people as well. And their job can be very difficult. I really see it there. We go to the Ministry of the Interior every day. We go to the trade license office every Monday, Wednesday, Friday. We go to all the social security, healthcare, tax offices everywhere. And they always have so many people there. And many of them are really rude. Many of them don't understand what they are saying. Many of them don't have the documents ready. So it's a very difficult job for those people as well. So if we are nice to them, maybe not in the short term, it usually helps in the short term run as well, that they will be nice back to you, but it helps mainly in the long term run, because they will see that not everyone is that rude, and they will see some hope, and they will give some of the hope back as well. So this is my opinion and my 6 tips on how to deal with Czech authorities. And now I'll go to the comments. I'm not sure if I can see some comments on Facebook, because this is the first time I'm doing live on laptop on Facebook. I usually do it from my phone. But I definitely have some comments here on TikTok. So let's see. Mokrá velryba, nedělej profesora, ty zmrde. Okay, that's a very rude thing to say. But I guess he's 11, so that's okay. then Joe Shepherd 95. I usually tell them that I have missing documents, that I'll send them by post, and they become nicer. Yeah, that's great as well. If you know that your application is not complete, then it's good to tell them, hey, I know I don't have everything, I did everything I could, but I just couldn't get this, but I will send it to you as well as soon as possible. That's a good tip, that helps as well, because if you tell them, yeah, I don't have it, and what? Deal with that. It's your job, not mine. Obviously that will work not that nicely. So if you tell them, hey, I know that I don't have it perfectly prepared, but I did my best, I have all the documents I could prepare, that usually can get you somewhere. So please tell me A1 and A2 language. Who's that? LXMN Arial. Well, there is not much to tell. Basically, from the 1st of September this year, the language requirement for getting the permanent residency was increased from A1 to A2 level. So now if you want to apply for a permanent residency as a non-EU citizen, not related to an EU citizen, then you need to pass the A2 level Czech language exam. So there is a website for that where you can check, you can do a dummy test, so you can see if you how well you are. You can like test yourself, and you'll see there's some study materials as well, and like how the actual exam looks like, what parts are there, and you can also have the audio there, and you can listen to that. So there is a good website. If you get in touch with me directly, I'll send you the link. Joe Shepherd 95, can I have a question? Can I ask a question? Of course, I'll be live for maybe 10 more minutes, slightly less probably, because some clients will be coming to meet me at 6. We'll be discussing a business visa, so if anyone of you is interested in doing, or you there on Facebook, if you're interested in coming to the Czech Republic and doing business here, or if you are already in the Czech Republic and you want to start your own business, start freelancing, get a trade license, get in touch, I'll be happy to help, or ask the questions here. That's why I'm here. And Bet Gear Badger 12, hello, hi. I'm sorry that the names here are always like, first, I cannot really see that. Second, they're always that long, so it's difficult for me. Hey, someone is want to join me, so let's...
Dobrý den.
Dobrý den, hello.
Hello.
Yeah.
Ciao.
How can we help you? How do you have any questions I can answer?
Chest?
Yeah, no. Okay. So thanks for joining.
Hey.
Hello.
Hey, ale 6 to není, to je přesila, to není fair. Ty máš 6 a 3.
Okay, fair, so prostě. Guys, I know how to get rid of this, I don't know. So good, perfect, thank you. Okay, so I'm waiting to be called for renewal of my permanent residence visa. I'm British. Okay. Go ahead. Because if you have a permanent residence permit, that's kind of easy to renew. There is You just basically submit the application form and now the stamps, and that's pretty easy. But if you're British now, you need to exchange the permanent residency, the booklet kind of, into a biometric card. That's a new requirement from the 2nd of August. So you need to exchange those for a biometric card. So you need to go to the biometric data to give your fingerprints, and they will take a photo, they will digitalize your signature and everything. So that needs to be done. Okay, so another part of the message, it's delayed. I thought they would call me. Should I go to them? Yes, for biometric. Well, I don't know exactly what you mean, because if you book an appointment for a biometric, it's not really possible to change it, because they don't really like it and they don't allow you to change the date for the biometrics. If you want to change the date, sometimes what happens is that if you don't appear there, that they will call you and they will offer you a new date. But I've only seen that a couple times. Usually they are pissed off and they will tell you that you need to send some official letter and requesting, like explaining your reasons why you couldn't come and requesting a new appointment, and then they will call you and then they will offer you a new appointment. But let me know if it's not what you meant, because I'm not quite clear exactly if this was what you were asking about. So I will go to the foreign police. Now you need to go to the Ministry of the Interior. People often confuse Ministry of the Interior and the foreign police. And I believe we've written an article about that on our website, movetoprague.com. Or if you find me on TikTok, I definitely shoot a video about that. What's the difference between the Ministry of the Interior and the foreign police? People usually think it's the same place, and it kind of is, because it can give you a lot of headache and they deal with foreigners and you always need to bring some documents. But the foreign police is a very specific place where you only go for very specific reasons. Anything you need to do with your visa or residence permit is done at the Ministry of the Interior. So some question from Facebook. How about the adaptation integration course? Do you have videos about that? Well, Chris, Andrea, that's a very confusing topic. Officially, starting from this year, everyone who gets a new residence permit should go through the adaptation course, or integration immigration course, integration adaptation, whatever is the name, which is basically a course that you will go sit somewhere into one of the NGOs. They will tell you what are your rights and what's the constitution in the Czech Republic. And that's it. You will get a certificate that you pass the certification or to pass the course, and that's it. You don't need to do any tests or anything. So it's nothing too bad. You just need to book an appointment for that and pay out of your own pocket. It's like 1500 crowns. But kind of who needs to do that and who doesn't is a bit confusing still. Because then in most cases, if you get a new card now, then you need to do it. But if you're, for example, extending your stay, if you have an employee card and you're just extending the employee card and hence you get a new card, but of the same type, then you don't need to do it. And there are a million other exceptions. So yeah, if you need to know something specific, please feel free to ask. I'll be live for like 3 more minutes. But if not, yeah, it's confusing. Yeah, it is. Even for us, I've read the rules like a million times and it's still not completely clear. So if you are asking if you need to do it, then get in touch and explain your situation and I'll try to find out for you and let you know. But otherwise, these were the general rules about that. Okay, Badger 12, thank you so much. Great to have your help. I'm happy if I take it as I was useful, that I answered your question. So I'm happy to hear that. And now LXMN Ariel. Last year I mistakenly print the date in tickets and police fine me. It's affect receiving PR card. Mistakenly print the date in ticket and I don't know exactly what you mean, but basically for the PR, for the permanent residency, if you had some criminal record that you went to jail or something like that, that could be a problem. That could potentially be a problem and the ministry could deny your permanent residence application. But if you just got a ticket from the police or if you didn't have a ticket for the tram and you got fined there, no one's gonna find out. So I would not be too worried about it. m.com for 13. You are our best Czech connection. Thank you. I'm happy to hear that. Guys, if you need any help, of course, if you have some question, please feel free to get in touch and just ask the question in private messages on Facebook or on Instagram, or like even comment on YouTube, or just like comment in one of my TikTok videos. Sometimes it takes me some time to reply those, because plenty of you write some messages to me and I do my best to reply, but it sometimes takes a long time. If you need any services, like help with your trade license, help with your visa, I don't know, help to find accommodation or help to get your health insurance, get into touch through our standard channels like a movetoprague.com website or Move to Prague Facebook, or just call us, send us an email, and we'll be happy to reply, because we have a team behind that who is always willing to help and who will get in touch as soon as possible. If you write directly to me, I do always my best to get in touch as soon as possible as well, but sometimes I need to prefer the client who pay the company for our services, so I need to prefer those and then do the rest later. So sometimes there can be a slight delay in that. So if you just have some easy, like simple question, go ahead, contact me anywhere directly. If you have some more complicated situation, or if you want to use the services we offer, then go directly in touch with Move to Prague, and we'll be happy to help there as well. Please send me effective links for PR. Okay, please get in touch. I'm not sure if you can like send me a message on TikTok if you're not following each other, but comment on some of my videos, or go to my bio. Now I don't have contact details there because we are still running the competition. So if you follow me on TikTok, one of the last videos is a competition where you can win some great Czech prizes, like a full package of Czech treats, sweet treats and some drinks and all this. And you can also win a discount voucher, or three of them actually, or two, one of them is already taken. So this is what I have in the bio right now, but I'll change it once we finish the competition and give away all the prizes. I'll put back my personal details like email, and I don't know, all the other contact details I have there. So feel free to get in touch, and I'll be happy to send you a link about the permanent residency. Or if you go to movetoprague.com/prague-blog, we have an article about permanent residency there as well, so you can find plenty of useful information there as well. Okay, guys, thank you very much for joining. This was a kind of different content that I usually do, but hopefully it was helpful as well. So thank you very much for joining, for supporting me, and I'll be meeting clients in 1 minute, so I need to say bye to you, but thank you very much. And if you need anything, let me know. Have a great evening. Bye bye. Thank you. Bye. Bye bye.